हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय थ्योरी ऑफ मशीन क्लास। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट थ्योरी ऑफ मशीन चैप्टर नंबर 1, दैट इज सिंपल मैकेनिज्म। एंड इन दिस क्लास आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट काइनेमेटिक लिंक, काइनेमेटिक पेयर, देन वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट काइनेमेटिक चेन, मैकेनिज्म एंड लास्टली मशीन। Then directly come to the first link or first article, that is link or kinematic link or element. First come to the definition. Each part of a machine which moves relative to some other part, then it is known as a link or kinematic link or element. Then, dear students, you know that each machine consists of several parts, and each part, according to the definition of a theory of machine, each part of the machine is known as link or kinematic link or element. For example, suppose we are taking an example of a IC engine. You see that this is the diagram of IC engine. In this IC engine, if we detect or want to select the parts of IC engine, that is how many links are there in an IC engine, then you see that cylinder and frame and cylinder all together constitute one link, that is fixed. If there is no relative motion between the cylinder and frame, therefore frame and cylinder constitute one link. And next link number 2, then piston. Why? Because piston is second another link, because piston reciprocates with respect to the cylinder, therefore cylinder link 1 and piston is our link number 2. Similarly, connecting rod and crankshaft constitute link 3 and link 4. In this diagram we can detect or we can select 4 links: link 1, link 2, link 3 and link 4. So respectively, frame and cylinder constitute one link, piston, connecting rod and crankshaft the other links. Therefore it is clear. Then the kinematic link, or simply we can say that it is a link. Link we can say also. Link means each part of a machine. Each part of a machine, every part of a machine is termed as link. Link means each and every part of a machine, but necessary condition is that it should have relative motion. It should have relative motion. Since frame and cylinder, between them no relative motion was there, therefore they constitute one link. Then next slide, that is kinematic pair. Kinematic pair is also very simple. As the name implies, that pair means connection of two links is constitute a pair. Then come to direct to the definition, you see that when the two links or elements of a machine, when in contact with each other, are said to form a pair. But that pair, if the relative motion between them is completely or successfully constant, then the pair is known as a kinematic pair. Then here our aim is to know the kinematic pair. Then kinematic pair, what is a pair? Pair means combination of two links. Combination of two links, here you can see the example. Combination of two links, this is our link number 1 and this is our link number 2. Link number 1 indicates by the color green color, and with the help of pink color we can detect or we can indicate our second link. And link 1 and link 2, when in contact with each other, how they contact? They joined with the help of a pin joint, so that they can move with respect to each other. If we make a welded joint or riveted joint, then they could not move with respect to each other. Therefore, link 1 and link 2 will constitute one link according to the definition of the kinematic link. But here we can join the two links with the help of a pin joint. Therefore, relative motion between the two links occur, therefore they constitute a pair. But when the pair is known as it is a kinematic pair or non-kinematic pair, for this we can distinguish about a pair from a kinematic pair. That is, if the relative motion between them means between the link 1 and link 2, if the relative motion between link 1 and link 2 is completely or successfully constant motion. Completely or successfully constant motion means, constant means restricted. Constant means restricted. Means in a definite direction. Motion in a definite direction. If we take a, suppose you can think a circular rod having a circular washer or circular collar. We can move the circular collar, rotate with respect to the bolt, or we can reciprocate the collar with respect to the bolt. In this case, the collar and the bolt constitute a pair, but that pair has unable to provide the constant motion, because there are two types of motion we can here takes place, because we can reciprocate the collar with respect to the circular bolt, as well as we can rotate the collar with respect to the circular bolt. For this, this is not a, or this is incomplete constant motion. Therefore, the combination of a circular bolt and washer or collar is not a kinematic pair, it is simply a pair. If we replace the circular rod with the help of a square rod, and the circular washer or collar with in the place of or in place of by a square washer or square collar, then in the case of a square bolt and a square washer, it is only possible to reciprocate. No circular motion will take place. Therefore, in that case, the motion is in a definite motion, is one type of motion, that is only reciprocating motion takes place. Therefore, that pair is, we can say that it is a kinematic pair. Then kinematic pair, you see that the example, here link 1 and link 2 constitute one pair, and that pair will, if we fix any one link, suppose I can fix link 1 and link 2 will rotate with respect to link 1, or vice versa. If we fix link 2 in place of link 1 or instead of link 1, then link 1 will rotate with respect to link 2. Therefore, the pair formed with the help of link 1 and link 2 will constitute one pair, and that pair, since it is providing completely constant motion, therefore it is known as, therefore it is called a kinematic pair. Clear, students? Next, I am going to the next slide, that is kinematic link and kinematic pair we have already completed. Then directly comes to the kinematic chain. Kinematic chain means, here earlier we can already discuss about kinematic link and pair. Two link constitute one pair. Here three or more links can form a chain, but whether that chain is known as a kinematic chain or not, here we have to see. Then first you just have a look on the definition of the kinematic chain. When the kinematic pairs are coupled in such a way that the last link is joined to the first link. Last link of the chain is joined to the first link in order to transmit definite motion. That is, we have already discussed about it. Definite motion means restricted motion or completely or successfully constant motion. It is called a kinematic chain. Here you just have a look on the example. Here I am taking four links, A, B, C, D. A, B is your link 2, B, C is your link 3, C, D is your link 4, and A, D is your link 1. And first link is connected, we are connecting the four links in such a way that the first link is connected to the last link. First link means link number 1, link 1 means A, D. A, D is connected to the link 4, link 4 means C, D. And here we can see that link 1 is connected to the last link, that is 4 link, at point D. Therefore, it is constituted or it is formed a chain is formed. But if this chain is able to provide constant motion or in a definite motion, then this chain is called, we can rename the chain as kinematic chain, or this type of chain we can say that it is a kinematic chain. If we fix, suppose take an example, if we fix link AD, if we cannot fix any link unless and until we are fixing one link of the kinematic chain, then we cannot recognize or we cannot demonstrate or we cannot observe the relative motion between the various links. Therefore, we have to fix one link. Here you see that if we fix AD or link 1, then the definite motion or the motions or relative motions of the other three links will be in a definite direction. Therefore, this type of chain is known as kinematic chain. Here, I can make a separate video about completely and successfully constrained motion. You can check in our playlist the constrained motion video. I can make a separate video about constrained motion. Here you can see so many number of examples there. Then any problem about students? Kinematic chain is clear. Then directly come to the next slide, that is mechanism. Mechanism, you see that this is the first chapter we are discussing about, the first chapter, that is simple mechanism. Simple mechanism, the word mechanism, what does it mean? The mechanism means when one of the links of a kinematic chain is fixed, then the chain is known as or termed as a mechanism. Here you see that the example, same example of a four links, because why we are always taking four links for a chain? Because if we are taking three links, then we can form a chain, but that chain is automatically a self-locking chain will produce. Therefore, in structures, in mobile tower or bridge or any truss structure arrangement, we can use the three links chain. But in case of machine, where relative motion, we want some relative motion, therefore we have to take four links, minimum four links, we can prepare a chain. From this chain, we can mechanism, always mechanism is formed from the chain. You see that when one of the links of a kinematic chain, here the kinematic chain is 1, 2, 3, 4, here this is a chain. Suppose we are naming it A, B, C and D. You see that A, B, C, D is a kinematic chain having link 1, 2, 3 and 4. Link 1 is your A, D, and link 2 is your A, B, and link 3 B, C, and C, D is your link 4. You see that here we are going to fix A, D, that is link 1, we are here, it is fixed. Suppose if when one of the links, any one link we can fix. Here I am fixing, in this example, I am fixing the link 1, that is AD. Therefore, it is the earlier, before fixing, it is termed as a chain. But after fixing the link 1, that is AD, it is renamed as mechanism. Then in mechanism, any one of the kinematic chain should be fixed. Then you can take any example of a mechanism. Mechanism means lever and crank mechanism, double crank mechanism, double lever mechanism. There are so many mechanisms are there in our mechanical engineering. You will study later. Then directly last point, I am coming to this last point, that is machine. What is machine? Machine comes from the word mechanism. You see that when a mechanism is required to transmit power or to do some particular type of work, then it becomes a machine. Here, in the last slide, in the previous slide, you see that mechanism. In that mechanism, four links are there and we are fixing one link, and if we rotate link number 2, then the link 3 and link 4 will oscillate. With the help of the same mechanism, we are going to produce or we are going to prepare one machine. That machine, here you can see that machine, because any mechanism, if we fix any one link of a kinematic chain, then according to the definition, we can find mechanism. Then if any kinematic chain has four links, then if we are going to fix one by link one by one, then we are getting so many number of mechanisms, that is four links means four mechanism. But out of four mechanism, those mechanisms who are able to provide or do, who are able to transmit power or to do some particular type of useful work, then that type of mechanism we can shed or we can reform it or we can redesign it to constitute or to design a machine. Here you can see that this is a mechanism, and here we can obtain the oscillating motion of the link 4. By the oscillating motion of a link 4 will converted to reciprocating motion of the piston. In this is known as a beam engine. Here the machine is known as a beam engine. You see that when the link 2, here what are the different links? This is link 1 along with this pillar, link 1, and this crank, this is link number 2, and this is link number 3, and the lever is link number 4, and this is this is our output of the machine. Here you see that whenever link 2 or the crank, suppose the crank is AB, when AB is rotated clockwise or anti-clockwise, that doesn't matter, but whenever the link AB will rotate, then what happens to the link number 3 and link number 4? The link 4 will oscillates with respect to the point. Suppose this point is O. With respect to the point O, the lever will oscillate, and that oscillating motion is converted to the piston reciprocating, or this oscillating motion is converted to the reciprocating motion with the help of this piston rod, and this is our output. And in this mechanism, what is the purpose? The purpose is to convert rotary motion into reciprocating motion. This is all about today's lecture. Thank you, dear students. We will see in our next lecture. Thank you all.